Coming up on Mountain News this morning, protesters in Ashland marched yesterday, even after organizers of the march backed out. And an Alabama man is making a 1,000-mile march to Minnesota. We hear from him as he made stops in Louisville yesterday. And as all of these protests are going on in the middle of a pandemic, we talk with health experts about how these gatherings could potentially further the spread of COVID-19.
Dedicated to Eastern and Southern Kentucky, this is WYMT Mountain News This Morning.
Good morning, I'm Lacey Roberts, and thank you for joining us on Mountain News This Morning. It is another start to a week on a Monday, and it was really hot outside this weekend, and we prepared you for that. But let's bring in Brandon Robinson to see just how hot it's going to be today. Good morning, Brandon.
Good morning, Lacey, and I think we're going to see a close to 90-degree day today. So, again, heat precautions need to be in place. Yesterday, not as bad as it was on Saturday, but still warm out there, especially in that sunshine. Let's take a look at Buffalo Mountain this morning, and you see things are pretty quiet there in Perry County up on top of the ridge where our transmitter is located this morning. We go to temperatures, and you'll see those are basically running in the 50s and 60s, 55 in Hazard, Irvin 2, 60 in Middlesboro, 63 in Pikeville and Jackson, 64 Somerset, London, and Monticello this morning. So no major issues with temperature. Iced coffee with your temperatures, but a little extra just because, of course, it's Monday. Everybody getting back into that Monday groove there. We'll take a look at the outdoor forecast, and you'll see those temperatures spike close to 90 today. Some spot may get to 90, an isolated spot there, but I think most of us stay in the upper 80s. Heat index not as bad today, but tomorrow it's going to be even worse. We'll talk about it coming up here in just a little bit. Lacey.
Thank you, Brandon. Protesters in Ashland marched yesterday after the original organizers of the march backed out. John Lowe has more about what those all who came out had to say.
For a couple of hours Sunday, neighbors in Ashland did what they could to come together.
You know, people need to be reminded, you know, that it's not about color, it's about unity. You know, people coming together.
Coming together for what they hope is the beginning of change.
Something has got to change. And it starts with us. And like I said, the generation before us didn't do anything to stop these things. So our generation are the ones coming out here to say enough is enough, and we're changing these old ways.
Despite losing support of the original protest organizers, people still came together to rally under the 13th Street Bridge, then marched down Greenup Avenue.
No justice, no peace. No justice, no peace.
Kneeling.
I can't breathe.
And lying down. For over 8 minutes each to memorialize George Floyd. And while the protest went smoothly, one of the protest organizers, Justin Thomas, said it couldn't have gone any better if it hadn't been for city officials.
They've been very, you know, very helpful. You know, they are, you know, been, you know, just, we couldn't ask for a better city to be behind us on this movement.
But through everything, protesters say it's time to start answering questions that are being asked all over America today.
It's how do people of color keep on becoming victims of police brutality? How is it, like, people like me, why are people so scared of me? Like, why are you so scared of my skin color?
John Lowe, WSAZ News Channel 3, Ashland.
Protesters in Ashland, those protesters did remain peaceful, and it did go smoothly with roughly 100 people taking part in that protest. And one Alabama man is making a 1,000-mile march to Minnesota. More than 250 miles in, Terry Willis made a stop in Louisville to pay respects to Breonna Taylor and David McAtee, both killed by police. He says he is mentally prepared to walk the whole day and share his message everywhere that he visits.
My God told me that I need you to walk 1,000 miles in Minnesota, but the reason is I need you to stop in other places and touch these hearts before you get there.
Willis has been sharing parts of his journey on social media, and some of his posts have even gone viral. And a GoFundMe page to support Breonna Taylor's family continues to grow. The fund was created by Taylor's aunt on June 3rd, and at last check, the total was more than $5.3 million. More than 180,000 people have made a donation, and the page says donations will go to Taylor's mother and sister, who are both missing out on work and sleep since Breonna's death. And while some people in Central Kentucky are taking to the streets and marching against racial injustice, others are taking a different approach. We've seen a number of vigils to remember lives lost to police brutality, and we saw the 8 minutes and 46 seconds of silence on Saturday in Richmond, and it was repeated in downtown Lexington yesterday. It is how long George Floyd was held under an officer's knee before he died. Participants were encouraged by the collective effort to bring justice and reform to their communities.
What you'll see is people coming together, and I really do think that that is our best strength. Our strength is our diversity.
A group in Richmond also held a similar vigil on Saturday, where, like yesterday, folks quietly whispered the names of those that were lost. And protests across the nation continue to spread a message against police brutality and an end to systematic racism in our country, all in the midst of a pandemic. Health experts and doctors have weighed in on how these mass protests could spread the virus. Dr. Ryan Stanton says it's highly unlikely we will see large increases of COVID-19 cases as a result of those gatherings.
I saw a lot of articles coming out like 2 or 3 days after the protest and saying that, look, the numbers are going up from the protesting. And it's not the case. We're not going to see a huge jump in 2 to 3 days or even a week.
The threat of COVID-19 has not stopped protesters across the state. They say we are currently in a battle with 2 pandemics. Well, thank you for getting your day started with us here on Mountain News this morning. Coming up, in the past weeks, we've all seen a lot of protests here in Kentucky, but on Saturday in Frankfort, it was a different story. We'll have the details.
The phrase that pays the next couple of days is heat precautions. We'll talk about how high the mercury will go in the next couple of days in about 3 minutes.